the 87th minute of the final match of Group D in the FIFA Women's World Cup 2019, and somehow, the whole world has stopped to watch what is about to take place. Having successfully scored two goals in quick succession after Scotland had been three goals in front, Argentina has received a penalty for a foul in the box, a penalty that might just tie the match and give them a chance to qualify for the knockout stages. Argentina's left-sided midfielder, Florencia Bonsegundo, steps up to take the spot kick that might just decide the match. A draw can be enough for her and her team to think about the round of 16. The same result will not be enough for goalkeeper Leah Alexander in her country. The ball is kicked and saved. Alexander screams with joy, and her Scottish teammates quickly swarm her to celebrate their moment of clear victory. However, the match is suddenly paused by the referee. Apparently, something isn't right. Alexander stepped off her line? The crowd rises up in fury as they question the VAR system and the referee's judgment, but it is too late. Bonsegundo is allowed to retake the penalty, she scores, and chaos breaks out as the match ends in a draw. The incident quickly becomes a massive controversy. Did Alexander truly break the rules? Did the referee really catch anything? Or was there something else behind this all? Was it just a better financial choice for FIFA to help Argentina progress than allow Scotland to go through? This, for sure, hasn't been the first FIFA controversy to shock the world, and it has actually become a recurring theme that the massive footballing body is increasingly being found guilty of involvement in dirty situations. In fact, today, we've compiled a number of issues going on behind the scenes at the footballing entity, past and present, that have put its reputation in question. Can FIFA be trusted? You decide. Let's start with number one, the arrests and bans of FIFA President Sepp Blatter and UEFA President Michel Platini. When you think of important men in football, you would surely consider the Swiss four times re-elected and worldly famous Sepp Blatter to be among them, especially as he oversaw four World Cups and received countless personal honors from grateful countries that were thankful to the man and his service. Michel Platini was equally as, if not even more, well-known and respected across the footballing world, regarded as one of the greatest footballers of all time, having won a previous record three Ballon d'Ors and the French Player of the 20th Century Award. Platini was already a legend before he was even elected as president of the Union of European Football Associations, or UEFA. However, in 2015, both of them were ultimately brought down by the United States Department of Justice, which also ended the careers of other huge footballing figures. Blatter, already surrounded by previous controversies in his last years as FIFA president, was caught for making a suspicious payment of over $1 million to Platini, and none of them could properly explain where the money had come from. The investigation, which was massive, involved over 20 different individuals in positions of power in the CONCACAF, CONMEBOL, UEFA, and other football associations, and ended with the discovery of over $150 million in bribes and payments made to corrupt international football. Sepp Blatter and Michel Platini have since been banned from participating in any FIFA-related activities until at least 2021, when their bans may be lifted. In our number two, we have the very suspicious awarding of World Cup 2022 to Qatar, a country not traditionally associated with football, guilty of harsh laws against homosexuals and alcohol, and fully willing to censor media to avoid any reputation-damaging news to escape its borders. The first time Qatar was mentioned as a potential World Cup venue was in 2009, when each nation's football organization was allowed to put their votes forward, after deciding that only non-UEFA nations would host the 2022 World Cup, as 2018's World Cup would be hosted in a European country, Russia. The actual votes began in 2010. Qatar quickly beat Australia, Japan, and South Korea by large numbers, and soon the final vote was between Qatar and the United States. Neither the press nor the public believed that this tiny Middle Eastern country, the smallest to ever host a World Cup, and a 32-team World Cup no less, would beat the US to the World Cup, but it happened, and they won considerably, in fact. But was it a clean vote? Apparently, there were many bribes that took place during the process which led Qatar to be selected as the next World Cup venue, many of which were all but confirmed when Sepp Blatter, who we already talked about and who was FIFA president when Qatar was chosen, was caught for his corrupt activities. As if all of this wasn't enough, hundreds of migrant workers helping build the stadiums in tough conditions and under terrible inhuman salaries have died, with human rights associations claiming that there haven't been enough measures put in place to protect these laborers from danger. Our number three on the list is certainly a subject that causes mixed reactions when mentioned, and has possibly brought about more bad blood between England and Argentina than the Falkland Islands ever did. Diego Maradona's infamous Hand of God. It was the 1986 World Cup, and two powerful nations were facing each other in the quarterfinals to see who would advance and face either Spain or Belgium. The match began fiercely, with both teams remembering the hatred that had spawned 4 years earlier in the 1982 Falkland War, as well as the ugly match that marred the English 1966 World Cup victory, in which the Argentine captain, Antonio Ratten, was escorted out of the stadium by the police after controversially receiving a red card and refusing to leave the pitch. It could be said that Maradona took dishonest revenge for his country when he jumped up in the box past Peter Shilton and swiped the ball into the goal with his left hand, pretending he had headed it. Running to the corner flag, he urged his teammates to celebrate with him to avoid his cheating to become obvious. They did so, but only because their star was asking for it. Everybody in the stadium had seen it and knew what Maradona had just done. FIFA for sure had seen it as well. So why was it allowed? Why was Maradona and Argentina allowed to get away with a goal that should have been a red card instead? Even if he scored an amazing goal only 4 minutes later and hammered the last nail into England's coffin, the story may have been very different if there had been no hand of God goal at all. Question for the ages. In our number four, we have the riots before and during the 2014 Brazil World Cup, which were sparked by general social discontent in Brazil, with citizens from all social and economic statuses begging for the World Cup to be canceled and for the money to be reinvested in other more useful things the government could offer. Starting during the 2013 Confederations Cup, in which Neymar and Brazil were the stars while Spain flopped, protesters began to fight for a better health system, education, public transport, food for the poor, and many similar types of social assistances, claiming that the billions of Brazilian reais being spent on stadiums and other aspects of the upcoming World Cup were going to ruin the nation. Representing one of the biggest footballing countries in the world, an immense number of football fans were among those against the World Cup being hosted in Brazil. And even Romário himself, yes, that Romário, was furious at the fact that billions of dollars had been wasted or even robbed during the organization of this immense event. After months of protests that left 42 injured and over 200 arrested, the demonstrations culminated on the night of the World Cup's final, as Germany scored the magical goal that would kill Messi's hopes of clinching his first trophy with the national team. A sour memory for the country all around. Our number five addition to this list is one that has always been discussed quietly in the dark, with many preferring to reserve their opinions. Do you remember the 1998 World Cup in France, and how two sides immediately began to shine from the moment the qualifiers started in both Europe and South America? 1998's World Cup, for all the accomplishments of Argentina, the strength of an amazing Croatian side, and the surprise early elimination of Germany, was a tournament in which all eyes were on the incredible Brazil and the formidable hosts, France. It must be said that from the beginning, all attention was on the immense stars that both teams offered, with the most attention on two. Zinedine Zidane, nicknamed Zizou, the French magician that succeeded at every pass, tackle, or shot he attempted from his playmaker position. And Ronaldo Luiz Nazário de Lima, or simply Ronaldo, Brazil's impressively powerful striker who was already a legend before he reached the World Cup final. And it is precisely about Ronaldo that we're talking about in this edition of our list of FIFA controversies. Brazil had a team that looked like it had been made in a child's daydream. The best left back in the world, the best right back in the world, a midfield like no other, and a front line that could have even broken into Fort Knox if they had wanted to. All of these bookies and experts were putting all the odds on Brazil taking the World Cup home with them, and it was as if France had no chance. They didn't, to be honest, since Ronaldo was unstoppable. But at the end, as the match began, it became clear that he apparently was unstoppable. He was, how to put it, something was wrong with Ronaldo as he walked onto the pitch with a strange disposition. Apparently, he had suffered from convulsions the night before the match and had almost been left on the bench, but an announcement had arrived that he'd been cleared as fit to play just 72 minutes before the match began. It was a strange twist of events, but even stranger was how ineffective he was during the 90 minutes that defined the end of an awesome World Cup, and where he faded. Zidane shone. Two goals by the Frenchman and one by Emmanuel Petit were all the Europeans needed. It was over for Brazil before they realized it, and the whole world suddenly asked, "What happened?" However, shock was just the initial reaction. Many believe to this day that something else was behind it. Perhaps FIFA had found it to be wiser to let the hosts win than this dream team from Brazil. Perhaps Ronaldo had been convinced somehow that he shouldn't perform and that there was something in it for him. Maybe it was nothing. Who knows? We'll question it forever, but the result won't change. Now, looking back at all of these controversies we've listed, it becomes clear that there is a real possibility that certain things take place behind the scenes that are just as dishonest as they are unacceptable, serving only to dirty the name of our favorite sport and making us question just how real are the results we see on a daily basis. Hopefully, there comes a day when we see a better, cleaner game without the corruption we've witnessed in recent decades, and that punishments are enforced. It will be a great moment for the sport.